Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out. Let it.
Welcome again to the presence of the Almighty God. We want to appreciate Him for what He has been doing in our lives so that you'll be able to make it to His kingdom on the last days. Brethren, the life we live now is very delicate because we're talking about Jesus coming. He can come any moment. But at the same time, it can also be coming for individuals at random. And this is where we need to start to live our lives right. Because yesterday, I thought about restitution. We don't know when the call will come for someone to come home. And there are things to be restituted that you have not done. It will be too late at that point in time. So, we need to manage our lives with wisdom, following the instructions of God. Today is Tuesday, the 19th day of September. And the topic that we have says, the grand is not for you. The grand is not for you. I want you to personalize it. The grand is not for me. And that will be your portion in Jesus' name. So we bow our heads to worship God that is prophesying to our lives today that the grand is not for us. Lift Him up higher. Lift Him up higher. My Lord is good. I will lift Him up higher. Anywhere I go, I will lift Him up higher. Oh, lift Him up higher. Lift Him up higher. Oh, my Lord is good. I will lift Him up higher. Anywhere I go, I will lift Him up higher. Father, we thank You. Mighty God, we worship You. The lover of our souls, we appreciate You. Thank You for yesterday, making it clear to us that we need to restitute. Father, as many of us that have made up our mind to restitute our ways, to settle every crookedness with men, Father, You grant us the opportunity and the grace to do it effectively and efficiently in the name of Jesus. So pray our Lord and our Father that today, as we have spoken into our lives, the grand is not for Your children. Any falling attitude in anyone that has kept one down, You will liberate Your children in the name of Jesus. Whatever situation that be making Your children one way or the other to remain on the floor after falling, You quicken our understanding together so that we will be where You want us in the name of Jesus. Lift up every head today. Lift up every head today. In Jesus' name, amen. Memory verse is taken from Proverbs 24, verse 16. Proverbs 24, verse 16, that says, for a just man falleth seven times and riseth up again, but the wicked shall fall into mischief. The passage to be read is in Luke 22:31-34. Luke 22:31-34 says, and the Lord said, Simon, Simon, behold, Satan has desired to have you, that he may sift you as wheat. But I've prayed for thee, that thy faith fail not. When thou art converted, strengthen thy brethren. And he said unto him, Lord, I am ready to go with thee, both into prison and to death. And he said, I tell thee, Peter, the cock shall not crow this day before that thou shalt thrice deny that thou knewest me. From this passage, you can see that it is possible for man to fall. Paul, as bold as he was, as dynamic as he was, if you read further, you will see how he fell. But thank God, we're still talking about him today as an apostle that succeeded because he did not remain on the ground. So, from this passage, you could see that Satan's desire is to shatter the life of man. He desired to shatter Peter's life. The same thing he's still doing today. He's still moving around looking for people to shatter their lives. Because in 1 Peter chapter 5 and verse 8, 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 8, it says, be sober and be vigilant, because your adversary the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking you he may devour, looking for people to shatter their lives. That is what he's doing. He is man's adversary. But for that passage, that same passage, another thing we can learn is that we thank God for Jesus' prayers. If not for the prayer of Jesus for Peter, he would have missed it completely. But the Lord prayed for him that the will of God, of the devil, will not be accomplished upon his life. So also, he has prayed for you and I. In John 17, verse 9, John 17, verse 9 says, I pray for them. I pray not for the world, but for them which thou hast given me, for they are thine. Jesus has prayed for us. And I know by the grace of God, his prayer will be answered for every one of us in the name of Jesus. No plan of the enemy will materialize over your lives in the name of Jesus. Want you to key into this, because Jesus prayed for Peter. He fell and he rose and became a mighty man in the hand of God. So if you're in a situation now that looks as if you are falling, Jesus has prayed for you. Arise on your feet. Confess your fall to him and he will see you through. It was the Lord's prayer that delivered Peter. Even though he trusted in his strength, yet he failed. Because he looked at the master and said, I even to prison want to go with you. Nothing can disturb me. But in 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 9, 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 9 says, for by strength shall no man prevail. No man can prevail by his own strength. You're strong physically, you're strong academically, you're strong financially, you're thinking you can stand the temptations of the enemy. It is not by human strength. It is by the prayer of the Lord. So, in verse 61 of that particular passage of Luke 22, verse 61, Luke 22, it says, and the Lord turned and looked upon Peter, and Peter remembered the word of the Lord, how he had said unto him, before the cock crow, thou shalt deny me thrice. And Peter went out and wept bitterly. He wept bitterly because by now he had denied the Lord three times. God will help us in Jesus' name. So by the reason of the prayer, we need to reply on this word. And we need to rely on the word that he has spoken in that prayer and not on our ability. There are possibilities of making mistakes, but we must be ready to make immediate adjustment. Immediately, Peter realized it when Jesus looked at him. He did not complain. He did not give any excuse. Bible says he went out and wept bitterly. Ah, I missed it. Ah, this has happened to me. He went out and he prostrated before the Almighty God and wept. Repenting and returning from evil is very crucial, like Peter did. So from the body of this particular study, it is a fact of life that we are all susceptible to making mistakes. As human beings, every possibility is there to make mistakes, because our wisdom is little, our strength is little. There's nothing that we have that can be compared to match what the devil has as an experience of life. He has been from the beginning. So, talking about experience, he has much more experience than anybody. And that's why we need to rely on God, who can give us power to overcome him. By human strength shall no man prevail. However, when we make mistakes, we must have the strength of character to admit our mistakes and also to resolve never to repeat them again. Never to repeat them again. Because when you make a mistake, you fall into this particular mistake, and you go to God and say, I'm sorry, O God. He's ready to pardon you, because he says, if you come unto me in repentance, he will forgive. But when it now becomes an habitual character, you're falling into it regularly. That's why Proverbs 28 verse 13 says, he that covereth his sin shall not prosper, but whosoever confesseth and forsaketh them shall have mercy. It's the part two that we're looking at. Confessing and forsaking is the one that we have mercy. If you are confessing and you are not forsaking that sin, mercy is not likely to come, because you have remained an adamant sinner, addictive to that particular way of life. A child learning to walk will stand up, make a step or two, and fall down again. You will observe, however, that in spite of these falls, he or she does not give up trying. That is it in the spiritual. You're walking on this particular pathway, you make a mistake, you don't need to sit down there. Arise again and continue. If you make another mistake, make sure that it wasn't the mistake of the past. It was not that former mistake. If it is another one, maybe God is teaching you how to move forward. And that's why we need more of the Holy Spirit, who can reveal to us things ahead of time. Because he will teach us all things, show us things to come. So, we need to behave like a little child. The child will repeatedly make attempts at walking, and in the process of time, that child will not only walk, he or she will also run, leap, and jump, all without falling to the ground like before. Now that he's gotten to maturity, it's gotten to maturity. I want to say that Christian maturity is a process. It's a process, like it is in the physical, in growing to maturity. A child will be a babe, will be a suckling, will be a toddler, before getting to maturity. And even at the age of 12, 13, you are still growing. So it is. But the expectations that are for the teenagers will not be for somebody for 3 years. He had grown beyond that. So it is with us in the spiritual. Our experience in the Lord, our knowledge of the Lord, our age in Christianity, we request for the different aspect of maturity. So do not turn a mistake into your final destination. Don't try it. Because that passage says, he that confesseth and forsaketh his sin shall have mercy. Can you believe that? Because some people made a mistake in their walk of faith in Christ, they came up, they gave up the race entirely and decided to die there. That is not right. My brother, that is not right. Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you. He wants you to come out of that situation. He wants you to leap up today now and start a new walk with him. He does not want you to remain in that particular state, because the blood of Jesus is the one that cleanses from all sins. Because in 1 John chapter 1, verse 9 says, if we confess our sins, he's faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. As we confess to him, he cleanses us, and our determination is we make up our mind never to remain in that situation anymore. And that from now, we are out of this situation because we are forsaking these sins. It's a determination for us to forsake the sin that easily besets us. That's why in Philippians chapter 2, verse 12, the later part there says, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. Work it out. Don't just stay put on the same level. Work it out. Now that you are born again, and there are besetting sins all around, it says, with fear and trembling, make up your mind. I'm forsaking this thing. I'm working out my salvation. God will help you in the name of Jesus. I would say, remaining in that particular state is an unfortunate one. Some people cannot forgive themselves for either denying Jesus at a very crucial moment when their faith was tested, or for falling into a particular sin that they have been preaching against all along. Some people find it very difficult to forgive themselves. But when God is ready to forgive you, why should you not be ready to forgive yourself? Such people need to learn from the example of Apostle Peter. Who thrice denied Jesus, the Lord had to make him realize that it was not over yet. So the same Peter was the one who later led the other disciples in defending their faith in Christ and in propagating the good news of the gospel around the world. So we see that Peter did a lot of things. He fell. He denied Jesus. And again, in John chapter 21, 2 to 3, John 21, 2 to 3, he later led the other disciples back to fishing. He led them to fishing. And despite all this, he was the one that God used on the day of Pentecost. The enemy did that to Peter, and Paul rose again. Peter rose again for the Lord. He also says that there is the possibility of a comeback. From where you fell, you shall rise in Jesus' name. Your rise shall be more formidable. You may say that your case is a bad one because you have fallen so many times, and you have therefore concluded that it was better to stop trying. Oh, how wrong you are. Proverbs 24, verse 16. Proverbs 24, verse 16, the memory verse, says, it is possible for a righteous man to fall seven times and still rise. It is possible for a righteous man to fall seven times and still rise. To fall seven times simply refers to the possibility of falling to a point of experiencing what most people will call the final and ultimate fall. Yet, even at that, if you are a child of God, the Lord says that you should not give up hope. Make another attempt at reconciling with the Lord. Confess your weakness to Him and ask for His help. He will lift you up and He will sustain you afterwards. So, are you still on the floor? The word says now, arise now. Arise now. Be determined to walk right with God. As you confess, be determined to forsake your sins. This is very important. Like we said, that you will work out your salvation with fear and trembling. Make sure that the fear of God reigns in your heart out of love for Him. Out of love for Him, the Almighty God will pick you up, and from now on, as you stand, you will never fall again in the name of Jesus. So the key point for today says, falling and rising in Christian faith does not make you a failure. It only shows that you are at the babyhood stage of maturity and will need to trust Jesus Christ the more. So, this is why we need to pray. Today, first you talk to the Almighty God, say, Father, deliver me from falling and rising. Deliver me from falling and rising. You know your situation, my brother. You know your situation, my sister. Yes, deliver me, O God. Deliver me, O God, from falling and rising. Talk to the Almighty God. He's a faithful Father. Deliver me. In this situation, my Father, my God, whereby we are falling and rising, deliver me in the name of Jesus. Deliver me. And now call on Him and say, Father, the grace with which not only to confess, but with which to forsake all my sins, Father, release upon my life. The grace with which not only to confess, but to forsake, Father, release on me. Talk to the Almighty God. Everything that has been a weakness in my life, every besetting sin, and Father, my God, the grace with which to forsake them, Father, release today. Mighty God, release today. Mighty God, release today. My Father, my God, that your children will be able to start to move in the right direction with you, my Father, my God. Release the grace with which to forsake every besetting sins. In the name of Jesus, every work of the flesh, Father, destroy in the name of Jesus. Go ahead and say, Father, move me to maturity with you. Move me to maturity with you. Talk to the Almighty God. Going through the process, my Lord and my Father, knowing fully well, my Father, my God, that it takes process to get matured. Father, every spiritual process that I need to go through, my Father, my God, lead me through them. Father, I'm ready. I am ready. for spiritual progress, and for spiritual maturity. I am ready. Lead me through the process, O God. Thank you, faithful Father. We appreciate you. Be thou glorified, be thou exalted. Thank you. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Mighty and eternal Father, I want to appreciate and bless your name because you are faithful. Thank you because you don't want anybody to remain on the ground after falling, because Jesus has died for every soul. Lord, realizing this, that if only we can confess our sins and forsake them, Father, you will pick us up again. As your children have cried unto you today, Father, as many as are on the floor, Lord, you pick them up and lift them up again in the name of Jesus. The way you showed Peter mercy, show all your children mercy in the name of Jesus. The prayer you have prayed for us, my Father, my God, Lord, let it work for everyone in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray that the grace with which not only to confess the sins, but with which, oh God, to really depart from these particular sins. Father, let it be the portion of everyone in the name of Jesus. Because it is he that forsaketh, that I confesseth and forsaketh, that receives mercy. Father, the ability to forsake, give to everybody. And today, we surrender to you, God. Lead us through the process, every process needed for maturity. And the end, take glory. In Jesus' name. Join us as we sing this hymn, Through the Love of God, Our Savior.
Thank you.
let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven.